Welcome back. Earlier on this channel, I had shown how to use K8s GPT with its AI capabilities to diagnose problems with a Kubernetes cluster. In that video, I demonstrated how to integrate K8s GPT with Azure OpenAI as a backend for doing the generative AI related API calls and to serve that response. That is a costly option because every time I analyze the Kubernetes cluster and identify the issues and look for solutions, I'm incurring charges because I'm using the OpenAI service to interact with that. It would be good if I can reduce those charges by using a local AI provider. And that is what we are going to do in this particular video. Before we start with this video, I would highly recommend that you subscribe to the channel so that you get to know when there are new videos published and hit that bell icon so that you don't miss any of the updates. Let's get started and see how to use the local AI as an option with K8s GPT. Now, when I looked at K8s GPT earlier, the number of providers it had was limited in number. Over a period of time, it has added support for other providers. So initially when I configured, I had the Azure OpenAI, and I think there were a couple of other providers. Now, if you see, the unused list of providers is quite long. And in this, there is an option to use the local AI, Ollama or OpenAI. OpenAI is the default one, in fact. So I want to show how to configure the Ollama or Llama 3.1 as the generative AI model as a backend for K8s GPT. In one of the earlier videos, I showed how to set up the Llama or Ollama as a tool to run the large language models locally on our workstation or on our machine. And here, if I run this command Ollama show Llama 3.1, this will tell me that I'm running a 8.0 billion parameters based model using Llama as the architecture, and it is Llama 3.1, which is the current version of this particular model. So I have this particular model running locally on my machine using Ollama as the tool. If you want to see how to set up this particular thing on your machine, you can have a look at the earlier video which I did on the channel. Knowing that we already have the Llama 3.1 model running, let's see how to configure it as a backend for K8s GPT. We add this as a provider for K8s GPT under the auth. So we have K8s GPT auth command with the add flag or the add option. And we are going to use the backend as local AI. And we provide the API server address here as the base URL. This is exposed on HTTP localhost with the port 11434 and V1 is the version of the API. And since Ollama supports multiple versions of the models which can be run simultaneously, we need to provide the model name which we want to use. I'm currently running only Llama 3.1, so I specify the model as Llama 3.1. Now, this particular syntax we can find from the documentation for K8s GPT, where for every supported backend or the provider, it tells us what metadata is required. And for Ollama via the local AI backend option, these are the parameters we need to provide. We can also use directly Ollama as option, but when I tried this, it was giving me an error. So I'm using this alternate approach to invoke Llama 3.1 API or Llama 3.1 model through the local AI option. So let's go and add this as the backend to K8s GPT. And now to use this backend, either we can set this as default or I can run the K8s GPT analyze command with the explain flag, which will invoke the AI backend, and we specify backend as the local AI. So although my default provider in this case is set as Azure OpenAI, because I am saying in this particular case, use the local AI as the backend. When it runs the analysis, we can see the AI provider is being used as the local AI provider. And we can also verify this by going into the output of Ollama, where we see at 427, there is an invocation and it calls the show API. So just about a couple of minutes back, it has invoked this particular API. We can also use the no cache flag here so that it does not use the cached output from the earlier runs. And in this case, it will force the execution, or it will go and request the information back from the AI backend. So that's where we see it's running this analysis again, and it takes a bit of time. But again, let's go back on the other terminal, and here we can see that it has called those methods, or it has called the chat API or the completions API again just a few seconds ago. So with that, we can see how easy it is to configure the local AI as the provider for K8s GPT and use the Llama 3.1 as the large language model. I hope you found this useful. In case you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence. I'll see you soon.